This video presents a model of a medical device startup company where the company's R&D activity is viewed as a continuous risk management process. The model utilizes accepted risk management methodologies to identify, characterize, and properly arrange for the addressing of typical challenges encountered during the company's R&D phase. It also highlights the intrinsic nature of the intercorrelated relations between these challenges. The video starts with a simplified scenario of an ideal world with no restrictions or limitations. This scenario is then followed by a series of scenarios of gradually increasing complexity, representing the intricacies of the real world. The intercorrelated risk set model is comprised of three components: an emoji representing an entrepreneur, a tubular optical instrument representing a typical set of challenges, and a light bulb representing a target, such as significant presence in the market or a successful exit event. At the onset of the model, the optical instrument is contorted and the emoji is naturally concerned. In order for the emoji to see the light, all bends should be straightened. Each bend in the optical instrument represents a specific challenge that needs to be addressed during the company's R&D phase, viewed as a risk to be mitigated. Typically, the risks can be divided into four main groups, each containing several challenges: the Gedanken Study Group, the Design and Development Group, the Verification and Validation Group, and the Pre-Market Group. The acceptable risk level mesh represents a risk mitigation threshold that is set per each risk component. Decreasing the risk level of the entire risk set below the acceptable risk level is a precondition for reaching the market. The mesh represents a minimal mitigation level, though preferably all risks should be fully mitigated before product commercialization. In an ideal world, the process of risk mitigation is sequential and fluent. Each risk is fully mitigated. When all risk components are nulled, the product is ready to be introduced to the market. In reality, it is impossible to address the entire set of risk components simultaneously. The very first constraint to be considered is the amount of available resources the company can devote for mitigating the various risks. At best, several risk components can be addressed at any given time. A lean startup company with extremely limited resources can practically mitigate only a single risk at a time, thus extending the product's time to market. Practically, a company's R&D phase is non-sequential and cash-consuming. This is demonstrated by the cash and fundability indicators on the lower right corner of the frame. Cash drains continuously due to R&D effort, while fundability increases as an outcome of the generated value. Value is generated by mitigating the various risk components, thus reducing the overall risk and making the company appealing for investors. For example, mitigating the Gedanken study risks is a precondition for seed funding. The process of risk mitigation includes intercorrelated influences. In other words, while mitigating a given risk, other risks might be affected. For instance, according to the results of the V&V effort, other risk components such as market, technological feasibility, or design and development might be affected. It is unlikely to conclude the process in a single run. Several funding rounds, trial and error iterations, and dead ends are to be expected before reaching the market. Planning for several R&D iterations is a good practice. Each R&D iteration should generate sufficient value added, thus making the company fundable for the next iteration. For each funding round, milestones together with the required budget should be well defined. The funding round must provide enough cash to successfully complete these milestones. Upon mitigating all risks below their acceptable level, introduction to the market can be considered. Yet, it is recommended to optimize the product by further mitigating the residual risks in order to lower future costs of imperfect quality. Often, the first funding round after the seed funding is the most challenging one. This funding round is commonly referred to as the Valley of Death. The seed money is normally limited, while the risk components of this early stage are at their highest level. Data show that most early stage medical device startup companies will run out of cash and halt any activity before sufficiently mitigating the key risk components, thus becoming practically unfundable. In the medical field, the most challenging risk components are typically design and development, IP, V&V, regulatory path, and reimbursement path. Failure to address these risk components may lead the company to a dead end. Typical failures are inability to utilize the chosen technology to meet the required product specifications, inability to protect the core intellectual property or to avoid infringing prior patents, non-addressable adverse results in laboratory, preclinical, or clinical studies, failure to receive regulatory approvals, or reimbursement policies that cannot sustain a viable business model. The key to increasing the likelihood of overcoming the above constraints is proper mitigation of the Gedanken study risk group. In this early and most important stage, fundamental questions should be deeply considered and addressed. Fundamental questions relating to the need risk may include, what is the medical need? Who is the product's end user? Occasionally, the need risk repeatedly changes as the medical problem is better understood. Fundamental questions relating to the market risk may include, what is the actual market size? Is it a new or existing market? Who are the main players in the market? Who will be paying for the product? And how much are they willing to pay? Fundamental questions relating to the technological feasibility risk may include, what is the most suitable technology for solving this medical problem? Is this technology evolutionary or revolutionary? Is it complex or simple? The chosen technology often changes during the development process. This can either occur in response to need or market changes, or due to limitations that are found in the previously chosen technology. The outcome of the Gedanken study is a business plan in which the fundamental questions are comprehensively addressed and the financial viability of the project is solidly demonstrated. A solid business plan outlines the expected risk levels along the remaining development process and defines the acceptable risk level in accordance with the specific project's requirements. For instance, determining that the product will be classified as a PMA typically poses a strict acceptance level on a series of risk components such as design and development, quality system, V&V, regulatory path, reimbursement path, and due diligence. By comparison, a Class 1 device allows for a more tolerant acceptance level for these risk components. The business plan should outline the upcoming key activities along with the resources required for executing them. As such, the business plan is a roadmap to market for the founders as well as for potential investors. Intercorrelated influences among the risk components are in fact more complex than shown in the previous examples. In reality, each risk component is both affecting and being affected by all the other components. These intercorrelations add a whole new level of complexity to the already challenging risks. Nevertheless, in many cases, the need component may be seen as the focal point of the entire set of risks. That is, mitigating the need risk substantially defines the remaining risks and reduces their uncertainty. Mitigating the need risk is an ongoing process where understanding the medical need constantly becomes deeper and clearer. Clarity of the need is a precondition for successful mitigation of the remaining risks and reaching the market.